As the day of battle dawns, Sunlight finds a sanctuary so secluded, some might say it's secret. But the day is not the only eye to spy this sacred spot.
Crack!
What strange beast is this come crashing in? Or should we wonder? Whose? Afro, found you at last! And you, I see, have found the perfect spot. Then again, you always do. Now then, to work! With a brief recess to slake life's little thirsts. And then back to it. The shopkeeper polishes his patter. You look like a hero who knows the value of a bargain. Might I interest you in the fabulous Eagle Song? No? You must have some use for the blood-forged Reaver's Axe. Really? But you do agree, heroic deeds ring hollow without Hyperstone. I'll just wrap it up, shall I? Now then, my lady, if I may prevail upon you just this one last time. Heave! Ho!
Not so secret now, huh?
Just keep your eye on the keeper and leave all the talking to me.
Careful how you play him.
Gentlemen, welcome to the secret shop. Can I offer you refreshments? I have strong black in quantity. My emerald teas are beyond compare. Or perhaps your taste run to Adelberry tinctures. Some think there is no finer way to drive off the morning dew.
Quite a shop you've got here. Quality.
We stock only the finest heroic supplies.
But I feel certain I've seen your faces before.
Could it be you yourselves are heroes?
I'm Sithel, and my friend here is Quirt. Our deeds have yet to win us honors. But while our motives are as lofty as your curious flagpole, we suffer from a lack of opportunity.
Heroic words, Sir Sithel. And speaking of motive and opportunity, perhaps I can offer a task. All but guaranteed to elevate your reputations to dizzying heights. For even would-be heroes, be they bold fellows, may perform feats worthy of the Elder Song. She is out there somewhere, gentlemen.
Listening, Quirt?
Lost on the field of battle, and I so desire her return.
Who is she? Your wife? Your mother?
Nay, a sweet, sweet relic, without which I cannot open shop. Surely you have heard of Demon Edge? When the mad moon tore asunder, and the ancients fell to earth, splinters of the Nemesis stones lay scattered. The demon smith Obsidian lay claim to two such fragments, and from them forged the Demon Edge. Her hilt of dire stone, cunningly carved, her blade a singing shard of radiant ore. But once the weapon was complete, he learned to his chagrin that only a hero could handle her. In testing her edge, the demon smith Obsidian slew himself. Since that day, Demon Edge has passed from hand to hand, though only heroes carry her for long. For in one weapon, warring ancients vie. And lesser mortals cannot wield such power.
Don't see how we'd be any use to you then.
Fear not. She was broken in battle. Hilt and blade lie strewn apart. Or so my source informs me. Indeed, Roclair. I'm sure they would benefit from your guidance.
I should hope.
Now, 'twould be naive of me to suggest that adventure is its own reward. And yet, as you can see, there is a gaping void in my inventory, which my customers will expect to be filled with the blade in question.
Well, it might be possible. Might, mind you. With a bit of persuasion, if that's the word I'm looking for.
Naturally, I will pay handsomely for the sword's return.
If you would excuse us, my partner and I need a moment.
Ask if he's got any animal tranquilizers.
Take all the time, you... Eh? Put that back! No dealing on this side, you.
I've seen all I need to see.
So have I.
He's fat with loot and...
We'll be back with your Demon Edge merchant.
Excellent! Roclair, if you would be so kind.
Don't get your hopes up, goat boy.
Now, Froll, you needn't give me that look. It's no worse than they had in mind for me.
Keep up!
What just happened back there?
What happened? Why, we got ourselves a job.
But I thought he was the job.
Wanted! Have you seen these rogues? Wanted for questioning in regards to the following crimes. Forgery, foistery, kidnapping, counterfeiting, looting, larceny, petty and grand, quackery, dispensing potions without a license, smuggling, bootlegging, contributing to the delinquency of a pack animal, robbery, highway, grave, and aerial, armed and unarmed, impersonating public officials, impersonating a hero singly and in pairs, general malfeasance, illegal collusion with known unsavory types, and other crimes too numerous and various to list.
Tell me again why we don't just...
Shh! The wind has ears.
Why, someone don't just knock over the keeper and take all he's got. He comes off as tough as a cream horn.
Who would steal from the secret shop? Keepers are favorites of the gods.
You're telling me no one's ever tried?
Many, but only one can be said to have succeeded.
Roshan, you mean? But he didn't just steal the Aegis of Immortality. He killed its keeper. Surely theft is only a minor infraction by comparison.
Test the gods at your peril, but consider Roshan, doomed to have his treasure stolen repeatedly and his life along with it. The gods do love an ironic punishment.
That tale's for frightening fairies.
Doubt if you will, gentlemen, it's of no consequence, for in yonder glade your quest comes to a head.
Can it be?
You may rely on it.
What the hell, bird?
Sorry! The chaos of Demon Edge's unmaking might have left me a bit confused.
Come down here, and I'll straighten things out for you. Starting with your neck.
There are actual heroes nearby who would be happy for my assistance. Shall I ascend above the canopy and seek them out?
No. The keeper is counting on us. Please lead on. Please.
Very well. It's only a matter of retracing my steps.
Steps?
Say you were an elder sword, forged by a demon, swung by a hero who fell in battle. Where would you be at this moment?
Under a pile of heroes' bones, most like.
Indeed, and there are many such piles ahead. Yes, it's all coming back to me now. Our destination is in sight. Do hurry!
You'll pardon us if we go more cautiously this time.
Cheery not, gentlemen. I can almost see it from here.
Careful.
Hear that? Down! Drow Ranger.
Shut up!
To be a hero, keeping such company.
Think she'd ever notice the likes of you?
If farmer hero she'd have to.
Enough of your fancies. Creeps are coming.
Look at those sorry dire troglodytes, never questioning their endless war, enthralled to a shiny old rock. And the radiant goons, don't be deceived. They might be nobler in spirit, but are they any more free?
Nothing's free, Sithel. Which reminds me, Bird, what good have you done? Where's our damn sword?
I have brought you to the very threshold. It is up to you to cross into the town of Roshan.
Him again.
This is most assuredly the place. Don't ask me how I could have forgotten the sinister town of Roshan.
Shut up, Bird.
I'll just hie me back to the Keeper then, where my words are met with appreciation. May the blessings of Skriok, the Vulture Goddess, shower warmly down upon you.
I wonder how many heroes lost their lives here.
Who cares about their lives? It's their loot that interests me. Now split up, and remember, Direstone Hilt, Radiant Blade.
Radiant Dire Hiltstone Blade. Ooh. If only me head was smaller.
Are we to believe, as the Bird implied, that Roshan stole the Aegis of Immortality from the secret shop?
Only if you believe in fairy tales.
You have no trouble putting faith in demons, yet you balk at fairy tales?
Demons ate me dear old ma'am while she was telling one.
Yet even heroes fear the town of Roshan.
Pah, it's just another mucky pool to me. Only thing we're bothering is frogs. Oi, what's this?
Drop it! The sword we're looking for is worth a dragon's weight of those.
You drop it.
Eh? Might it be? It must! I'd best take care not to cut myself. But it's devilish hard to get a grip without a hilt.
Hilt, you say?
So, Demon Edge, you mean to resist me? What's that? You've met my like before? I assure you I have many means of persuasion at my disposal. And sometimes even a thinking man must resort to brute force!
Sithel, mate, I think I've found... Oh, hells. Run, Sithel! Run!
We're not here for the ages, if that's a concern.
Hey, you! Get away from my friend. Fairy tales.
My keeper sends regards, Roshan. Flee, you idiots!
So, are we heroes yet?
That, my friend, depends on how we dispose of the loot.
You should see the other guy.
So, this is solid dire stuff, eh? Same as the ancients made of.
Never thought I'd get close to a shard of radiant ore. It exerts a strange influence.
Mind if I...
Hands off!
Well, same to you!
I've no interest in your grubby lump of dire with its foul emanations. Why, it hardly deserves to share the atmosphere with this radiant beauty.
Wait a minute. Where are we headed?
Back to the secret shop, of course, to return these goods to their rightful keeper.
A keeper? He's got a thin claim, if you ask me.
I didn't ask you. The quest we accepted...
That was you! I didn't agree to nothing!
Among noble creatures, one's intentions count more than legal agreements.
Noble? Who am I talking to all of a sudden?
I might ask you the same. Your slurred vernacular and hunched gait make it plain the low company you prefer has had a coarsening effect.
Fancy words ain't gonna fool me into giving up this rare bit of loot on the say-so of a keep shopper and a known backstab such as yourself.
Let me offer some simpler words then. I swear on my soul you'll surrender that hilt if I have to run you through myself.
You blimey snake! You've been planning to treacherize me this whole time, ain't you?
My motives are honest and pure. Two concepts I'm quite sure have never compromised your dull and solid wits.
You leave my wits out of this!
To think I trusted you! Never again!
Same here!
Get away from that! Demon Edge
belongs to me!
Get it here!
Not a chance!
We come, comrade!
To our kin's defense!
Dire wretches!
Radiant scum! That mine!
Not so!
Are you joking me? No, my sword!
Oh, brother, stand firm against the dire!
Eh? Aye, the dogs deserve death.
Got it!
For the Radiant!
Chisel, it's me! Chisel?
It's awful quiet. Be a shame to set off at arms and wake everybody. No reason business can't wait till sun up. I'll just find me a place to pass the night. So only heroes can carry her, huh? Well, I seem to be doing all right. It's almost like she wanted me to have her. I did go up against Roshan in single combat, more or less. That's a bit heroic. I can't help but notice she left Sithel to his radiant fate, but saved me to carry her off. And if I am turning out to be a hero, it's just as well I don't tempt myself hanging around that shop. I'm likely to lift something just out of habit. Nah, better to put some miles between me and them old temptations. Time I started acting like the sort of hero this here sword would want me to be. Demon Edge, I think I'll keep you.
Who's that? Hey! Mine! Yeah? Now look here! Oh! That's better. Can't move! Oh, God, no!
It has been a pleasure.
I assure you, the honor was all mine. Quirt, is it? I must thank you, sir. I had a fine feeling when I saw you skulking about. I once squatted where you squat now, and in a few centuries, you may well find yourself in my position. Every decade or so, some idiot doubts the stories. Depend on it. Allow me to impart one final bit of advice, gleaned from many years of trial and error. Lift with your legs, not your back. And with that, good Sir Quirt, farewell.
Please don't let that rooster crow!
Not long after.
Good morning, my lady. Your strong black is ready. Well now, what do I spy? Ah, the lovely Demon Edge. I knew you'd make your way back somehow. You always do. I've no idea how you manage it, but no matter. Roclair!
With pleasure.
The end-ish.
Missing! Have you seen us? Unsavory associates are bereft! Help to mend a shattered guild! Sithil and Quirt are sterling members of the Rogues Guild, only slightly behind on dues. Misunderstood by a fettered society, but beloved by their likewise frowned upon peers who consider them exemplary practitioners of illicit arts. Unheralded by authorized bards, their names remain synonymous with cunning and duplicity. Tireless recoverers of ancient artifacts, charitable to fae folk, unstinting instructors of neophytes in the arts of knavery. Please report any information to the Inn of the Silent Braggart, Sly Cuddles, proprietor. Last seen near the secret shop! Our cronies miss us.
Of course, all that was a long, long time ago.
Oi, back when Roshon's tarn was still a watery mess and not a pit of lava.
It took some years of scheming to spring my friend from his entrapment.
You took your time about it.
Time spent doing my utmost to avoid becoming one more victim of an appallingly high creep mortality rate.
Admit it, you've always had a fondness for the Radiant.
It's true, I do look dashing in green.
You got off light. I'm scarred for life. All those years of wearing an ass for a hat.
The next round is on Quirt. Let's just say he's coming to a new source of income.
I wish you wouldn't advertise that. The Keeper might not want it getting around that he's doing deals with unheroic types like us. Besides, he had good reason to get rid of this thing. It's as much pest as blessing. Though to be sure, it do have its advantages.
End